And we also have a few pictures of her personal effects, which I'll show you, that she was found with. I can't really show you the clothing because of the condition of the clothing and the condition of the body when she was discovered. But I can show you the jewelry. Daryl Zorins was our investigator, who was a person on call, who got the call and went to the scene. So I'll have Daryl talk about that briefly, and then I'll show you the pictures that we have.
Thank you, Doctor. We received a call for a female that was found in a mulch bed, partially decomposed, at an apartment complex. There were children playing in the area that noticed the body. They went and got an adult. The adult then called police and emergency services. It was discovered that there was, in fact, a human body remains in the mulch bed, partially wrapped in some type of cloth, with a flower of some type that was laid upon the chest of the body. And we're just asking for the help of the general public, because we have exhausted all of our means.
To identify her, yeah. So I've got some sketches, and you'll be provided those so that you can actually put those out there. This is a forensic artist's depiction based off of the markings that they use on the skull of, and what we know, and also the forensic anthropologist's opinion and of what she might have looked like. And in the past, they've been pretty accurate. It's amazing how they do that. I'll provide this for you so you can take closer photos. She also had some earrings on her and some black rope bracelets. And those are here, and we'll provide you those as well to help identify her. And just so you know, upon autopsy, the forensic pathologist did not feel like there was any foul play. So we don't anticipate that this is a homicide. I mean, somebody took the time and trouble to try and bury her, and, you know, considering it was so shallow in a mulch bed, maybe they didn't have tools to do any more than that. She was found with a flower on her chest, and there wasn't any outward signs of homicide. So we just need some help trying to find out who she is to try and give her family some closure. You know, we've had some pretty big successes in the last couple of years of, you know, people that have been unidentified for 6, 7 years or more. In fact, we had one from 2009 that was recently identified, and her family was in Ticonderoga, New York, and had been waiting for years to find out what had happened to their loved one, and we were finally able to give them closure this year. So it's important. It's important because somebody's looking for their loved one at some point or other. And, you know, in that lady's case, her mother was in the nursing home and was just so happy. I'm getting chills even talking about it. Was just so happy to just know what had happened to her daughter before she passed away, you know, before the end of her own life. So it's important. And that's why we need your help.
Can you talk about the extent of decomposition? Any idea when she may have died?
You know, that all varies based on temperature, the humidity of the air, and, you know, it was May 31st, so it was fairly warm. So we think it was at least a couple of weeks, but it's really hard to give you more than that in the way of time, unless you can track back the weather patterns well.
So she was partially buried, but she was concealed somehow. How did no one see her before these kids?
Well, you know, with the decomposition of the body and the mulch and the color isn't too different, and so she was only partially seen, and maybe some of the mulch washed away from her body after some rains, and so that's why she was discovered. She might have been better covered at one time, but with weather and changes, she was a little bit more exposed, so.
Any idea of a cause of death?
No, and that's, you know, we don't think it was homicide, but there wasn't any clear indication for cause of death. And also, because of the decomposition of the body, it's a little difficult sometimes.
What's your best guess of what she was doing in this mulch bed or why she got there? I mean, that's really...
We don't know. I mean, at this point, we're thinking, you know, natural causes, or we couldn't rule out an overdose, really, but it's hard to tell.
You kind of touched on it, but how difficult is this? That it sounds like somebody tried to take care of their loved one and tried to do the best that they could, but the best they could was literally a mulch bed next to it.
Yeah, we don't know if she was homeless or if she was with somebody. We don't know the status. I mean, I think that somebody tried to take care of her, it looks like. And, you know, somebody asked, well, could they have been trying to hide a crime? Well, it doesn't really feel that way, and we're not suspecting foul play. So if anybody knows anything, especially the person that might have partially buried her or tried to bury her and she didn't, we're just looking for some information so we can give some closure to her family.
What does a flower tell you?
Well, if somebody's trying to hide a crime, and, you know, how many bodies have we found along the side of a highway, for example, in the last year? This was not that. This was somebody who took the time and trouble to place a flower on her chest, you know, and that's very different than the way we find bodies along the side of a highway.
More mysterious too, isn't it?
Possibly.
Anything you can say about the flower itself?
I think it was a rose.
In season and bloom something.
I think it was a long stem rose. Yeah. I think it was a long stem rose. No, it was a real flower. Yeah. Yeah. Any other questions?
I think you mentioned back in July when we talked to you about it, what was she wearing? It was like gray, silky pajama pants.
She had three layers of clothing, if I remember. She had a tank top, a t-shirt, and kind of a wrap sweater or something on top of that, and then some looser pants. And there was a name in the tag of the pants, but, you know, we just never know if that's an accurate name or if it was, you know, if they got it from a thrift shop or a shelter. You know, whose name it might be. So we never go by that. We try and scientifically identify somebody. Anything else?
I have none.
All right. Thank you all very much for coming.
Thank you.